Hey guys, I've had a couple of students very concerned that they don't know how to approach this Bayesian modeling stuff. So for project four, I think it's actually quite simple. You probably collected some data with a sensor where you had one situation and then you changed the situation and you collected some more data. And all you have to really show is that something changed, that there was a different result in one condition than in the other condition. That's probably the simplest possible scenario. So the particular question that I was asked involved accelerometer data, where they were rotating the orientation of the accelerometer to demonstrate that it was different one way than another. So what I want to do is just go ahead and show you, if you had data like that or any kind of data where, like, some people were measuring temperature, so they had a temperature in one situation and then they changed the temperature and they measured the temperature again and they want to just demonstrate that they actually measured something. So that's really the simplest case. Now sometimes you want to show a relationship between two variables or two measurements that you made, and in that case the situation's a little different. Let me go ahead and I think it's already installed. Yeah, I already installed it here, but you need to install PyMC3 in RViz if you want to, if you haven't done that already. So I can say import PyMC3 and then import RViz. Okay, so those are the two main packages we're going to be using. Of course, we'll also be using NumPy and pandas, and probably matplotlib. So our old friends. Okay, so let's go ahead and load some data. So I was shared some data. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab it and stick it up there. Here. It's called xpos.csv. You can see it's XYZ, and then that's not really time. I think that's probably just a counter that's counting the number of measurements they made. But you can see X is a big number, and Y and Z are fiddling around zero. But the point is, before I look at the data, the idea is you want to model it before you look at the data. So you want to model. So let's say we'll call AX1, AY0. This is my model. I want to make a generative model first. So I want to generate some data that looks like this data, and then I'm going to analyze the data that I fabricate and see that my analysis system actually produces sensible results. And then I'll try it on the real data, and then we'll see how we're doing. Okay. So let's go ahead and let's say this is, I'm going to call this AX theory, AY theory, AZ theory, right? Those are that's my underlying reality. And then I'll say AX gen. This is the generated data. And how many data points? I think they had 100 data points in their data set, so I'll make this 100. So I want to generate data that looks like real data. And to do that, I'm going to say, I'll make a variable called noise level. And that's just the random sort of additional noise that pops in there. And looking at the data, I don't know. It looks like it's probably 0.01 or something like that. So I'll just call it 0.01. Okay, and then to generate the data, I'm going to do a normal distribution. And arguments are loc and scale. Loc is the mean, and scale is the standard deviation. So I'll just say loc is going to be AX theoretical, and scale is going to be noise level. Okay, and then size will be N. That'll be how many data points I generate. And then I'm going to do the same thing for Y. And we'll just copy that. Except it's going to be AY theoretical. And then same thing for z, except this is going to be az theoretical. Okay? So that's going to be my generated data. And then maybe I should plot that. We'll make x is blue. Y is green, and well, let's make Z red. Okay. And something I did wrong. AY, oh, it's not equals, it's comma. Okay, so my x data is up here bouncing around near 1. My y and z data are bouncing around 0. And that's pretty similar to what the data actually looks like, right? I've got random variations about 1. I've got random variations about 0 for the other two. Okay, so that's my generative model. So I'm generating data that smells like, it's not the same as real data, but it has the flavor of the real data, and I can use that to test my analysis to make sure I'm picking up the right answer. So let's, I'll go ahead and put a title on this guy. And data index. And this is acceleration component. And this is measured in G's, I feel certain. Okay, perfect. So now let's analyze this data. So I've got generated data in X, Y, and Z. What kind of model do I, what parameters do I have? Well, basically each of these is supposed to be a single number. So all I really have is the three numbers, AX, AY, AZ. And then I've got the noise level. And I'm going to assume all three components of the acceleration have the same noise level. So let's go ahead and say with pm.model, I'll create a model. And I'm going to say, let's give it a name as acceleration model. And then we'll go ahead and add components to that model. What are our parameters? AX is going to be, let's make it just a normal distribution. Now this is our prior distribution for AX, and the fact is we don't know what AX can be. It could probably be most of these accelerometers go plus or minus 3 G's, so we could say mu equals 0. The average will be 0, but we'll give it a wide standard deviation. So I'm going to assume that the acceleration is somewhere between plus or minus 3 G's, so let's say sigma equals 3. Okay, there's another distribution called the Cauchy distribution that has wider tails. That's also decent, but for the purposes of this, I know the acceleration is going to be somewhere between plus or minus 1, so I give this a nice wide sigma. I know that as a prior distribution, I want to make sure I include anything that could possibly be the right answer. And this should include plenty of range to make that happen. I'll do the same thing for AY. Mu equals 0, sigma equals 3, and then AZ, and then call it AZ, mu equals 0, sigma equals 3. Okay, so those are the prior distributions for the three accelerations. Notice the whole point of the prior is you don't know the answer yet. You're not putting the answer in. You're putting in your prior information, which before I see the data, I really shouldn't have looked at the data, but I know that these accelerometers have a limited range of acceleration they can measure. So that doesn't push the thing in any particular direction. And then what about the noise level? So I'll just say noise equals PM dot, let's make that, I know it has to be positive, and I know it's much less than 1, so if I start with a uniform distribution, and I'll just make it between 0 and 1. Okay, so that's our model. Now, the main thing, you know, each system will be different. The main thing is all the parameters that you need to find have to be specified in the model. And then the question is, what am I going to observe? So I'm actually going to observe AX observed is going to be a, it's also going to be a PM normal. It's a normal distribution. Its mu is going to be AX, but its sigma is going to be noise, because that's where the noise comes from, right? It's that noise level. So this is the actual distribution of data that's producing this fluctuation. It's got a mean of my measure, my theoretical value of AX, right? That's what I'm going to call my result, the value of AX. And it's got a sigma that's equal to that noise level. And I'm assuming the same noise level for all three signals. So that's a shared parameter. But these ones are observed. So I'm going to say observed equals, and the observed is going to be my generated data. Now, when I'm fitting real data, I would put the real data here. But here I'm just testing my generative model. And so I'm just checking to make sure that the analysis works, right? This mu is going to be AY. This sigma is going to be noise. And observed is going to be AY gen. And AZ observed will be PM normal. I realized I left something out. This should have AX observed. I always have to make the first argument the name of that variable that's going to be stored in the trace. AY observed, AZ observed. Perfect. Mu is going to be AZ, right? Sigma is going to be noise. And then observed is going to be AZ gen. Okay. And this is acceleration generative model. Okay. I'm analyzing the generative model. And now I'm going to say trace equals PM dot sample. Let's go ahead and just do 1,000 samples, and let's make this return inference data is true. Okay. All right, let's run it. So it takes a while. The first time you run it, it takes a while because it has to build that model. It actually writes a C program or C++ and compiles it. So it takes a while the first time. Okay. I think that's... Oh, it's running 3. Okay. It finished. All right, so let's go ahead and then see what we got. So I'll say az dot plot az dot plot. I thought it was az plot trace. That work? AZ. Oh, that's the problem. Oh, okay. I use the same name AZ as we have up here. Let's do this. AVZ. Okay. And then I can say AVZ plot trace. And it looks like we got AX is between 0.998 and 1.03. AY is near zero, AZ is actually, interestingly, it's not near zero. It's actually less than zero. And the noise level is about 0.01, so that wasn't a bad guess. So anyway, that's how it turned out with, and we can get the stats. So let's print AVZ dot summary, and then we'll say kind, oh, trace, kind equals stats. And then that should show the mean and the standard deviation. So standard deviation is, these are pretty tight, right? So that's 94% of the probability is between 0.999 and 1.003. So these guys are clearly extremely different. Let's see what it looks like with real data. This was with my generative data, my fake data. Let's actually use the real data. So what I want to do is load in xpos.csv. So I'll say df equals pandas read csv xpos.csv df. Let's look at it. Okay, x, y, z, and time. So what I want to do here is say x, ax data, actual data, is df dot x. Or actually, I don't even need to do that. I can just, let's just build a new model with real data. So I'm going to copy all this code. The only thing I'm going to change is instead of calling this the generative model, I'm going to call it acceleration data model. So this is with real data. And instead of ax.gen, I'll do df.x. So I'm just going to put in the actual data from the data frame. And then we'll run it. Done. And now I can just say AVZ dot print, no, print AVZ dot summary kind equals stats trace, and then AVZ dot plot trace of the trace. And this is the actual data now. So it looks like the actual mean, it was significantly higher than my generated mean. But of course, I used a AX of 1. But the actual AX, it looks like, is actually higher than that. It's 1.005. AY and AZ are very nearly equal to 0. And the noise level was actually, let's see, was it? Is this my. That's my real data. The noise level here was higher because I put it in higher. The actual noise level in the real data is only 0.004, so it's about half as much as I had in mind. But the beauty is, I used a generative model to test the analysis concept. The concept clearly worked. Then when I tried it on the real data, I had a high level of confidence that it was going to work. Okay. The standard deviations here are very tiny. So, but you can get from the confidence or the credibility, the interval of credibility, you can see that 94% of the probability is between 1.004 and 1.006. It looks like AY and AZ are both a little bit negative, but they're very tiny compared to AX. Anyway, that's the idea. So that's how you use a generative model to validate your a Bayesian inference procedure to make sure you're doing something intelligent. You could do the same thing if you rotated the sensor. You could do the same thing with the other directions as well. And then your main argument is that my AX was, you know, somewhere between 1.004 and 1.006. And there's no way I can confuse that with the AX when I rotate the sensor. It's very different. It's closer, much closer to zero.